ISUPK.
About this Bible. The ISUPK is not affiliated with any religious group or organization.
Good.
Today, we're going to learn about this Bible. The Bible does not have religion in it. So Pentecostal, Egyptology, Islam, Roman Catholic, Baptist, you name it, is not in the Bible. According to this Bible, it was written to the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man.
Right. Right.
And when we look at today, the pastors of all these religious institutions keep telling us that Christ, that we know as Jesus Christ, who is Yahweh Shai in Hebrew, died for everybody. But according to this Bible, that is not so.
That's right. Right.
And we're going to prove this according to the Bible.
Right.
Give me Matthew 1:21.
The book of Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21. And she said, bring forth a son.
Right. This was the prophecy of Christ coming to Mary. Go ahead.
And thou shalt call his name Jesus.
So Mary was going to have a son. And his name would have been Jesus.
Right.
Which is Yahweh Shai in the Hebrew.
Right.
Go ahead.
For he shall save his people.
That's right. And the scripture says he was not going to save the whole world. Who was he going to save?
He is going to save his people from their sin.
That's right. Christ was coming to save his people from their sin.
Good.
Now the question will be, who is Christ's people? Who is Christ's people on this earth? And we're going to find out. Give me Luke 1:16. We're going to find out who is the people of Christ on this earth. A lot of people walking around here today in Port of Spain and do not know that you are the children of the Most High.
Right.
And that your king is a black king.
Right.
A black man written in the King James 611 Bible.
Right.
Named Jesus Christ, known as Yahweh Shai in Hebrew.
Right.
He is your king.
Right.
Go ahead.
The book of Luke chapter 1 and verse 68. Blessed be the Lord thy God of Israel.
What does that say?
Blessed be the Lord thy God of Israel.
The scripture in Luke 1:68 firstly says, blessed be the Lord God of Israel. Did it say the word?
Good.
Did it say the word?
God of Israel.
It said the Lord God of Israel. And now we're going to understand who the Most High people is on the earth.
Right.
Now we're going to understand that Christ did not come on this earth for everybody.
Right.
Go ahead.
For he had visited and redeemed his people.
He visited and redeemed what?
His people.
Right. Christ came on this earth and visited and redeemed his people. Go ahead.
Verse 69.
Go ahead.
Verse 69, and had raised up an horn of salvation for us.
So the Most High raised up a horn of salvation for us. The horn of salvation is Christ. Go ahead.
In the house of his servant David.
In the house of his servant David. Christ came directly in the lineage of David. Go ahead.
Verse 70.
Go ahead.
Verse 70. And he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets.
And he spake this by the mouth of his holy prophets. Go ahead.
Which have been since the world began.
Which have been since the world began. Continue.
Verse 71. That we shall be saved from our enemies.
That we shall be saved from what?
Our enemies.
That we shall be saved from what?
Our enemies.
This is what the black man, the Hispanic man, and the Native Indian man don't understand.
Right.
We are walking around not knowing that our enemies are against us.
Right.
They have taken over our internet and media and blast you with white images.
Right.
Telling you that the prophets are white, Christ is white, God is white, and we keep taking in all these images, all these movies in our theaters and showing on our television, telling us that these holy people of the Most High is white. But according to the Bible, the true Jews of the Bible is the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man.
Right.
We are the Jews of the Bible.
Right.
And if you don't understand that, we're going to understand it a little better. What we're going to understand is that the people in Betham, that's God's people.
Right.
The people in Lavantel, that's God's people.
That's right.
The black man in Labre, that is God's people.
That's right.
The black man in Point Fortin, that is God's people.
Right.
The black, Hispanic, and Native Indian people walking around here today are the true Jews of the Bible.
Right.
Go ahead.
And from the hand of all that hate us.
That's right. And he is going to save us from our enemies and all those that hate us. And what we don't understand, that every nation on this earth hate the black man.
Right.
Every country you go to, they hate the black man.
Right.
They say they love you, but why are you continuing to be in the bottom of society?
Right.
Who is standing up for you? Who is standing up for you, black man?
Right.
Who is picking your people off the corner?
Right.
Who is saying no more drugs coming into your community?
Right. Right.
Who is bringing in these drugs on the port? They hate your people.
Right.
Right. Who is bringing in these guns on the port? You feel we can afford an AR-15 or an AR-45? You feel we can afford that? Which little black boy in the ghetto can afford these guns?
Right.
But all of a sudden, they're coming in on the port in plastic. Understand? And they want to blame you. Use the end product. They drop it in your community.
Right.
And they let life circumstances, poverty, take destruction and take hold of our communities.
Right.
And watch us kill one another black and forth and say it is our problem.
Right.
But according to this Bible, they don't like us. They
right.
brought drugs to our community. They brought the guns to our community. They are the cause of the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man destruction
right.
in society today. Go ahead.
Verse 72, to perform the mercy promised to our fathers.
That's right. And the Most High is going to promise the mercy that he has promised to our forefathers. What our Christian pastors and religious leaders does not want us to know is that the laws in the King James 1611 Bible, we were supposed to keep these laws.
Right.
These laws was given to the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man. And we broke these laws. The breaking of the laws is what caused sin. Get that. 1 John 3 and 4. Bible for sure. You gotta understand what is sin according to the Bible. It is not a religious thing. This is breaking the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Most High. 1 John 3 and verse 4.
1 John chapter 3 and verse 4.
Go ahead.
Whosoever committed sin, transgressed also the law.
That's right. So the Bible is simply explaining that sin is the transgression of the law. And what our Christian leaders does not explain to us, that the laws, statutes, and commandments of the King James 1611 Bible, when we break them, that is what causes sin.
Right.
That is the simplest explanation for sin. Give me Matthew chapter 10 and verse 5, Baba Kusha. Now, we're going to understand who Christ, who Yahweh Shai, was sent for. Christ was sent for the black man, the Hispanic man, and the native Indian man. And we're going to show this in the Bible. Go ahead.
Matthew chapter 10 and verse 5.
Go ahead.
These 12 Jesus sent forth.
That's right. These 12 Jesus sent forth. So Christ was getting ready to send forth his disciples. Go ahead.
And commanding them, saying, go not in the way of the Gentiles.
And he commanded them, saying, to go not in the way of the Gentiles. Don't go to the other nations. Go ahead.
And enter the city of the Samaritans.
And don't go into the city of Samaria. These nations did not have Israelites living in them. Go ahead.
Enter you not, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
Go rather to what?
But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
That's right. They were supposed to go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And the reason why the sheep is lost is because they don't know they are the Most High's chosen people.
Good.
They don't know that they are the blacks, Hispanics, and native Indian man. They don't understand that they are the chosen people of God. Right? Give me Jeremiah 31 and 31. The black man walking around today for Spain, your Christian pastor has not been telling you the truth. They want you to come and keep paying tithes and remain ignorant of the scriptures in the Bible.
Good.
They try to understand. They want you to understand, right? That Christ is, the white Christ is your master. But according to this Bible, Christ is a black man.
Good.
With white woolly hair.
Good.
Christ was a Negro man.
Good.
The prophet was black. Christ is black, the Messiah is black,
right.
And even the angels is black.
Right.
Go ahead.
The book of Jeremiah chapter 31 and verse 31. Behold, the day come, saying the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel.
That's right. The Messiah say the day will come when he will make a new covenant with the house of Israel. He is going to make a new covenant with the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man. Go ahead.
And with the house of Judah.
And with the house of Judah. In the Judah and Israel make up the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. Go ahead.
Verse 32. Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hands and bring them out of the land of Egypt.
Right. So it's going to make a new covenant. Not according to the old one we had when we came out of Egypt. Go ahead.
Which my covenant they break, although I was a husband unto them.
That's right. Although when the Most High say he was a husband unto us, he was a protector over the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man.
Right.
And we broke the Most High's covenant. So he set a new covenant for us. Go ahead.
Right. Saying the Lord, verse 33, but this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel.
So this is the covenant that he's going to make with the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man. Go ahead.
After those days, saying the Lord, I will put my laws in their inward parts.
So the Messiah is going to put the laws in our inward parts. Go ahead.
And write it in their hearts.
That's right. And Mark 7 and 21 says the heart is the mind. So the Messiah was going to put his laws in our mind, go ahead.
And will be their God, and they shall be my people.
And what?
And I will be their God, and they shall be my people.
No, he will be the whole world God.
And they will be my God, and they will be my people.
No, he will be the Chinese God.
And will be their God, and they shall be my people.
He was going to be the God of the black, Hispanic, and native Indian man.
Right.
According to this Bible, this God is the Lord God of Israel.
Right.
It never said the whole world.
Right.
That is what we fail to understand. The black, Hispanic, and native Indian man walking around in society to today is the chosen people of the Most High.
Right.
Give me Romans 9 and verse 3, Baba Kusha.
The book of Romans chapter 9 and verse 3.
Go ahead.
For I could wish that myself were cursed from Christ.
So Paul is saying he could wish that he himself was separated from Christ. For what?
For my brethren.
For his brethren, say, go ahead.
My kinsmen.
His kinsmen, his family, go ahead.
According to the flesh.
That's right. So Paul's family and his brethren was according to the flesh, go ahead.
Verse 4. Who are Israelites?
Who was Paul's family?
Who are Israelites?
Paul's family was a black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man. Paul belonged to the tribe of Benjamin. And what people don't understand is that the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man make up the 12 tribes of Israel in the Bible. Right? Go ahead.
To whom pertained the adoption?
To whom pertained what?
The adoption.
So belonging to the black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man pertained what?
The adoption.
The adoption.
And the glory.
And the glory.
And the covenant.
And the covenant.
And the giving of the law.
And the giving of the law. The black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man, the scripture says, we were supposed to be the priests and kings of this earth.
Right.
But we broke God's laws.
That's right.
And now we are in the bottom of society. Right? Give me Matthew chapter 27 and verse 35. Now we're going to understand that Christ came for his people. And the people of Christ were the real Jews of the Bible.
Right.
The black, Hispanic, and Native Indian man. Those were Christ's people. Christ came for the nation of Israel.
Matthew chapter 27 and verse 35. And they crucified him.
This was Christ. When they crucified Christ, go ahead.
And parted his garments and casted lots.
And parted his garments, they took away his garments and they casted lots for his garment, meaning that Christ didn't have no linen. They cast lots for his garments. You wear a royal garment, go ahead.
That it might be fulfilled.
That it might be what?
That it might be fulfilled.
Go ahead.
Which was spoken by the prophets. They parted my garments among them, and upon my vesture they cast lots.
That's right. So before even Christ was crucified, the prophets already prophesied. Let's go ahead.
Verse 36. And sitting down, they watched him there.
And when he was crucified, they were sitting down, watching him up there crucified. Go ahead.
Verse 37. And set up over his head.
And over Christ's head. Right? Go ahead.
With
accusation.
Accusation written.
And over Christ's head, the charge that he got was written over his head. Go ahead.
This is Jesus, the King of the Jews.
It said, this is Jesus. Or Yahweh Shai in Hebrew. And it said, this is Jesus, King of the Jews. It did not say King of the world. What did it say?
This is Jesus, the King of the Jews.
Right. Christ was King of the Jews, not King of the world. He wasn't the King of everybody. Christ died for the black man. Christ died for the Hispanic man. Christ died for the Native Indian man.
Right.
We are the ISUPK coming out of 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yohana. And we are not affiliated with any Israelite group or organization.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, so packed, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road, like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's already turned from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good wreck. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? With them the breath of life, I'm believing fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain. Something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord?